our channel. In this video, we are going to dive into something super exciting, integrating AdMob interstitial ad into your Flutter application. Interstitial ad are full screen ads that cover the entire interface of your app. When until close by the user, they are great for monetizing your app without interrupting the user experience too much. Before we get started, make sure you have the following prerequisites in place: a Flutter project setup, an AdMob account if you don't have, sign up at admob.google.com. First, we need to add the AdMob Flutter package. Open your pubspec.yaml file and add the following dependency. Run Flutter pubget to install your package. Next, we need to initialize the AdMob SDK. Open your main.dart file and add the following code inside main function. First of all, you need to initialize the interstitial ad into a variable. We can make here private variable for the interstitial ad, so it cannot be accessed outside the class. After that, we create a function, private function, to create interstitial ad in our class. We give it name as a create interstitial ad, and we need to load the interstitial ad inside the function. Interstitial ad.load function takes the parameter ad unit id, which is your AdMob interstitial ad id. Request is add request. Add callback are the functions which give the unloaded information on add field information. After add is loaded, we need to set our previous interstitial add variable by the new loaded interstitial add inside the set state function. Now, when add field load, we print the error message in our console. There are many functions or callback in interstitial add.load function, so you can use according to your need. I'm only using two of them in our tutorial example. Now it's time to create the function to show the interstitial ad inside our application. First of all, we check the interstitial is not null so that we can do the further things to our interstitial ad. First of all, we check the full screen content callback so that on ad dismiss, after user dismiss the ad, we can dispose the ad and create new ads. And further, on ad failed to show the full screen content, then we also dispose the ad and create another interstitial ad and show the interstitial and ad. After showing that, we set the interstitial ad value to the null, so that by this way we create a function to show the interstitial ad. Okay, now moving to the UI part, we create a button to show the interstitial ad in our application. By pressing the button, elevated button, we can show the interstitial ad in our application. And now the final part is to initialize the interstitial ad in our init state function, so that it can load interstitial ad when app is started. Now the most important part is, do not forget these things to add in your application, otherwise your application throws an error or may occur error while building or launching your application into the emulator or real device. First of all, add the metadata in your Android manifest.xml provided by the AdMob. And the second part is to make sure you have minimum SDK version said to be 21. It is required by the Google AdMob package. So you do not forget to set the minimum SDK version to 21. Thank you guys for watching our video. If you like our video, do not forget to subscribe, share and like. Thank you. See you in next tutorial.